Do you consider yourself politically liberal or conservative?
Liberal, like every other Carleton student.
Liberal.
Politically liberal.
Very liberal.
Liberal.
Well, when I had Facebook, I certainly had my political views as being very liberal.
Rather liberal.
I consider myself moderate.
More on the liberal side.
Absolutely liberal.
How about apathetic?
That's liberal.
I'm generally liberal.
Liberal.
I'm moderate.
Politically liberal or conservative?
Conservative.
You're like the wounded gazelle that the hyenas pick from the back of the pack.
Have you had experiences where you personally have felt like you've been put out by people for expressing your views, or?
Yeah, I'd say last year on 5th Watson, I called out all those kids. There's plenty of times where you're sitting around those lounges, you know, you see everybody up there on Watson, sitting around, just kind of shooting the breeze, and politics comes up, and as soon as you say something that's not in the same way as they're thinking, they just gang up on you. That's it.
People here often don't even listen. Like, I can't, there are so many times in which I've laid out reasons why I'm conservative, reasons why I think McCain is more qualified than Obama, and it always comes back to the same thing. Well, why would you want, you know, 4 more years of a Bush presidency?
I can definitely feel I'm in the political minority. I mean, it's not, you know, people won't come up and be like, oh, you're crazy, conservative, or something like that. But generally in conversations, you know, if I say, oh, I'm going to go hunting over winter break, you get a lot of weird looks like, what? You're doing what? So it's, you know, your values are different, your lifestyle is different. Sometimes people judge.
I mean, I've had like a negative reaction from the students, but not the professor. The professor is usually just trying to moderate the discussions. I mean, there's been a few times where I've definitely been like a very vocal like minority in like a class.
I've taken one poli-sci class. The professor was really great about making sure that everyone felt comfortable. I'm the only class that comes immediately to mind right now that has politics perhaps where it shouldn't be is my English class. Involves every once in a while, I guess, good-natured ribs at the Republican Party, which I have absolutely no problem with. But I've heard stories from other people, especially people who take more poli-sci type classes. I mean, I'm a math major, it hardly comes up often in most classes I take.
In this very classroom right here, this education class I took, when I decided to write a paper against affirmative action, that was not received very well. I remember my partner, I gave, you know, we had to switch copies and read a rough draft, and like, I read the comments, and the first comment was, I completely disagree with what you're saying, you know, this and this and this and this. And I just felt very attacked. It's almost like boxing, you know, where you're sparring with someone, and, you know, they try to hit you really hard, you're gonna hit them hard back. So, yeah, that's probably, or at least that's me.
I know there's a lot of conservatives who don't want to identify as such, and who don't like it if we necessarily mention that they're conservative on campus.
I really just kind of stopped pushing really hard what I truly believed, because it was pointless.
Most of my political discussion goes on with people in the CCU. If for no other reason, at first it was to avoid dirty looks and the like. I'm the vice president of the CCU, which means I help the president, David Rosenberg, running weekly meetings and kind of plan events and various things for the club. We're nonpartisan. We don't support, or I should say endorse, any candidates, parties, anything. We're primarily focused on discussion. We talk about our views. We talk about, I guess, the origins of the conservative movement, various parts of that. And it's mostly debate and open discussion format. There's certainly a good degree of judgment that comes along. For example, during tabling this year at the club fair, we actually had a bit of fun waiting for people to come closer and then watching their face to see their expression as they read the sign that said what we were about.
Oh, it's so open. It's so great here. you know, we really get to express our views. Yeah, you get to express your views because you're a liberal. I mean, I can tell you that right now, that person who said that is liberal. That if you're a conservative and you start expressing views left and right, I mean, people are going to jump on you. My girlfriend jumps on me for doing it. So I know if she's going to do it, then everybody's going to do it.
I think there's kind of the assumption that you come here so you must be a liberal. And that's definitely, I mean, I think a problem. I mean, there are a lot of people I found at Carleton who aren't necessarily liberal but identify as such. Not because they necessarily believe in it, but because it's kind of like the popular culture of the school. And I think that's kind of an issue that needs to be addressed. Like, I mean, you should have beliefs because you actually believe in them, not because everyone else does.
If everyone around you is a liberal, it's much easier to not listen to the other viewpoint, and it's also much easier to just sort of like think I have the right idea because everyone's around me.
I think just be more open. Just take into account what is going on politically in the world. You know, take the stance that you believe is right. You have to look from the other side and be like, well, what are we really doing to the minority here, which would be the conservatives? You know, are we letting them speak?
In the morning and I ask myself, is life worth living, should I blast myself? I'm tired of being poor and even worse, I'm black, my stomach hurts, so I'm looking for a purse to snatch. Cops give a damn about a Negro, pull a trigger, kill a he's a hero. Get it back to the kids, who the hell cares? One less hungry mouth on the welfare. First ship them, don't let them deal with brothers. Give them guns, step back, watch them kill each other. It's time to fight back, that's what Huey said. Two shots in the dark, now Huey's dead. I got love for my brothers, but we can never go nowhere.
Consider yourself liberal or conservative?
Sexually?